All right, Nate, take us through. You guys finally had some time to watch some film on Villanova. What do you guys know about them?
Yeah, I mean, overall, they're going to be a pretty good team. They had some success in the Big East, came up short, but there's a lot of good teams. So they're definitely going to be a team to watch out for. But I think we have our game plan pretty well set, and I think we'll be ready to go for Thursday night.
Nate, what does it kind of say about this program that you guys are in a position where you're hosting a power conference team in the NCAA tournament game?
Yeah, going into it, we weren't sure where exactly we'd be seated. And at the selection show, we were just hoping and had our fingers crossed that we'd be able to host a game. And then our wishes came true. So we're very grateful for that. And it's just really important to us and to just the game in general for us to be able to play at home and play in front of our home fans and just be, just at our home place, because that's a huge, huge advantage for any team that's able to play at their own field. So we're just really happy and excited for that opportunity, and we're looking to take full advantage of it.
How does Nova kind of, what team do they maybe compare best to of the groups that you guys have played so far this year?
I would say maybe in terms of just how competitive they are and how disrupting they are, I would say maybe Albany. I think they're able to possess the ball a little bit better and just play better soccer overall than Albany is. Even though the two teams have very different styles of play, they're both the same way in intensity of play and just how close they'll play you and just how aggressive they'll be. So we're just looking at ways to get around that. And like I said earlier, our game plan is set up to counteract that. So I think we'll be okay.
What are the emotions of this team right now, just one day away from hosting?
Yeah, I mean, I think some of the guys are still riding out the high of winning the championship, myself included. Obviously, it's something that we've been working for and just something that we were really excited about. And it's just the aftershocks are still there, but at the same time, we have to get in the right mindset of flipping the page. Once you get into the tournament, it's a whole new ball game. Anything can happen. So anything that you did in the past doesn't really matter. The fact that you're there is what it comes down to. And once you're there, you just have to focus on playing your best and going game by game and trying to get as far as you can go.
Now, I think Rob mentioned a little bit ago that you were planning on taking advantage of the extra year. Is that accurate? Are you planning on coming back?
Yeah, so based on when I got here, I obviously had the red shirt year. And then the past year of COVID made it so that I do have an extra year to be able to play. So with that being said, it looks like most likely I'll be back for another year. Nothing's guaranteed yet, but if I had anything to say about it, I'd obviously want to be able to come back and get another run at it, be here with the guys and just be able to go out and perform for the team. So yeah, I wouldn't say it's not off the table, and it's very likely.
So for you, this isn't necessarily the end of the road at Virtue, but obviously there's going to be a number of guys, seniors this year, that probably, regardless of the result of this game, this is going to be the last time that they get to play. How much is that kind of in the back of your guys' minds, just in terms of kind of wanting to send the guys that are leaving off right with a win there on the turf over there?
Yeah, so for guys like me, I'm lucky enough to be able to have the opportunity to, if I wanted to come back, I'd be able to. But yeah, just for the other seniors in that position, those guys, I mean, I don't want to speak for them, but I just know they would want nothing more than to be able to win another home game and potentially be probably their last home game that they'll ever have at Virtue. So I think it's really important that myself and just the entire team as a whole honor those guys and go out on Thursday night and just try to play our best and hopefully get a result so that they can go out with one last win on Virtue Field as seniors.
You guys been able to have any conversations with any of the guys maybe 5-6 years older that did have the opportunity to play a home NCAA tournament game and kind of get their thoughts on that?
Yeah, so one really popular guy that I'm sure everybody knows is Brian Wright. He was actually down here with us because his season was over. So he was able to come down and be there for us and witness us win the championship and just be there to just support the guys in general, because out of a lot of the older guys that have been around, he's been one of the most like consistent guys that have been in the picture, just because he lives close by and he's just like a staple of the program. So having him here to like mentor the guys and just make sure everybody's doing the right things and share his experience and what it takes to win at that level and in a game of that magnitude, it's really valuable, and we're really appreciative of that.